Hello, today we are going to study the monitoring systems on DraughtRim. So first we are going to see the types of monitoring systems that are available. The monitoring system is supposed to keep a check on the following things. And the first thing it's supposed to keep a check on is the process as well as the quality. The quality terms are like count deviation alarm is there, then there would be some system to correct the irregularities. Like auto leveler, which we have already seen. Then there are certain indicators that are given by the machine, like spectrogram. This also we have studied in detail earlier. All these help in correcting the faults in the machine. The production levels also are checked by such monitoring systems. So things like stopping of the machine, if there is any creel break, or if there is a production loss due to roller lapping, all these are measured, and a record is kept of all these things. That means if the stoppage of the machine has happened, it has happened how many times and for what reasons, all these records are kept so that we can analyze them and take appropriate action. The objective of the monitoring system, whether any kind of the monitoring system that we may use, it helps us to ensure that the process does not produce unacceptable material and that the machine will run at full efficiency. Data provided by the monitoring system, let us see what kind of data it provides. So this, in case of sliver count, it is continuously measured by sensors and recorded on a chart. Also, there is an hourly or a daily average count check that is there, and it will record the percentage deviation from nominal, and at the same time it also records percentage mean deviation of sliver hang for the entire shift. The machine is stopped when the count varies beyond a preselected length. Reasons for count variation may be creel breaks, roller lapping. There are some other reasons for count variation, that is, there may be a missing or extra sliver feed, incorrect draft or feed count, or setting of the auto leveler. Because of all these reasons, you may see a count variation. The machine may stop if the irregularity exceeds the decided limits. If you see if the machine measures a high amount of irregularity, it will automatically stop. The indicators, as we already know, are spectrogram and U percentage, which are the monitoring systems for quality. Reasons for irregularity may be defective machine parts, roller lapping, defective auto leveler, insufficient doubling, imperfect setting of drafting system, and partly suctioned of sliver due to the powerful suction in the drafting zone. Also, damaged card clothing, comber piecing. Comber piecing we shall study later on when we study comber. Also, incorrectly coiled sliver could be some of the reasons for irregularity. Some of this we have seen earlier, and we have also seen the remedies, while some of them which have not been discussed earlier will be discussed later in this lecture. We'll see the remedies for how we can fix them. Production data like idle condition of the machine, that means how much time the machine has remained or has stopped in the entire shift. Reasons for stoppages are also recorded, and a number of stoppages with efficiency, and also canned offing time. All this data is readily available. So now let us take a look at some norms or standards for CV and U percentage. We should know how much CV or U percentage we are expecting at DraughtRim, what level of CV would be called as good, average or poor. Same goes for U percentage. So there are some CITRA norms, and the CV percentage of the DraughtRim sliver are as given below. Suppose the wrapping length is 0.5 meters. That means we are looking at the CV of sliver which are of cut length 0.5 meters, like half a meter. And if the CV percentage is 2%, then it would be a good sliver. If it is 2.5, that means if CV increases, it will be somewhere coming in the range of average. And if it is 3, it will be poor. Now, as you go to the next wrapping length, suppose we take, instead of 0.5 meters, we take a 1 meter cut length and measure the CV, then the good value would be 1.75, 2.5, 2.75. And respectively for average and poor. Then if we go further and increase the length, and the cut length becomes 5 meters, then in that case, the good CV value would be 1.25. If it increases to 1.5, it will be coming under the category of average. And if it further increases to 1.75, it will be a poor sliver. Now, one thing we observe here is the CV goes on decreasing as we increase the cut length. The standard goes on decreasing. So, why the standard has been reduced is because the when the cut length goes on increasing, the averaging effect is there. So, because of the averaging effect, lower the standard, a lower standard needs to be decided. And that is why you see this kind of a difference. So, sliver uniformity or U percentage. In this case, let us see the source of sliver and if it is coming from card. The values between 3.5 to 3.7 would be good. A value of around 5 would be known as average. And a value of 6 would be a very poor sliver from the card. So, we can look for defects or the reasons for this kind of ununiformity and fix them. Coming to draw frame, the values for carded drawn sliver is 2.25 to 2.5. Average is 3 and poor is 3.5. And for combed, it is 1.75 to 2. As you can see, for a combed sliver, the sliver uniformity norm has gone down and the standard has become stricter now. Similar in the case of here, when we saw that the length has increased, the norm became stricter. Same way for case is seen here. In case of comb, it has become stricter because after combing, it is expected that the sliver uniformity should improve. And that is why you see a stricter standard. Then when you come to a combed sliver, it is 3.3 to 3.5 after combing. This is what we are talking about. After combing, if we were to take the uniformity, the norm has become slightly less strict here because we will always see some kind of defect which is known as a piecing wave in the final combed sliver. So we see an average value of 4.5 and a poor would be 5.5. Of course, the piecing wave, etc., we will be studying under when we study Comber syllabus. So, going to the next slide. This is a table which shows the possible reasons for various count variations, irregularity, periodic variation, etc. So, and also it shows you the remedies against it, what action can be taken to set it right. So let us go row wise. The first one is the roller lapping. Now roller lapping would be a result of worn out cords, damaged flutes, scratches on the rollers, excessive roller pressure or RH percentage inappropriate, trash in feed or honeydew in cotton. So to fix this, some of the remedies could be we reduce the front roller speed and roller pressures, increase cord hardness. Action is taken so that we reduce the surface contact at the nib, because the moment we reduce the surface contact, we can say that the fibers sticking to the roller, the effect would be lesser, and so increase in cord hardness would help roller lapping. Also, we can try reducing the static generation. This would happen mainly in the man-made fibers. So in man-made fibers, if I want to reduce static generation, what I should do is maybe I reduce the speed to reduce friction between the fibers, which will reduce static generation in the first place. Or I can increase the spin finish, which is basically a lubricant, to reduce the static generation, which will help lesser sticking of the fibers to the rollers and reduce roller lapping. So coming to the next reason for count variation would be if in the card, suppose some web is missing, that same is reflected in the sliver that comes on the draw frame. So if the reason for count variation is found in the card, then we should check for damaged cylinder or doffer clothing or lapping at the card. So we must go and fix that. Coming to the next reason for count variation, it is incorrect count of feed. Missing or extra feed sliver, completely or partially suctioned of sliver, incorrectly set auto leveler. So when all these reasons are, these are the remedies are very simple and straightforward. If it is incorrect count, fix the count. If it is extra or missing feed sliver, you have found the reason to be that being the reason for count variation, see that the missing or the extra feed saliva does not come in. If the suction is too high, just reduce it so that it doesn't suction off the saliva. And if there is some problem with autoleveler, you go and set it right. So a remedy is taking an appropriate action. So now we come to the next kind of problem that we may face on the draw frame, that is irregularity. If it is too high, the reasons may be fiber shedding. That means a lot of fiber is being thrown out, or rather it's coming out of the web. So what we can do is we increase the relative humidity of the atmosphere, which will make the fibers more cohesive and remain in the web. I can also reduce static generation, because of which the fibers may be sticking to the machine parts, or maybe just because they do not have enough cohesion, they must be getting released into the atmosphere. So these two would be the remedies for fiber shedding. The next possible reason for irregularity is roller slip. So in this case, we can try and increase the roller pressure after checking it if required. Then another possible reason for irregularity would be defective autoleveler, insufficient doubling, correct trumpet size. We have seen this, the trumpet size, how it is important in for compacting the saliva that is delivered. And we have discussed at length in that particular lecture about the size and how much it should be and so on. So you can always refer to that lecture. Then defective machine parts or drafting wave due to wide settings, piecing wave and comber, incorrect tension draft at creel and web, and roller lapping. These would all result in irregularity in the final sliver. Now again, whatever reasons are given here, they have been discussed in the respective lectures, say on drafting wave and so on. The piecing wave and comber would be discussed under comber. So all other things are very clear, like defective autoleveler, so you need to just go and fix them. That would be the remedy. So for all of them, you can just take appropriate action as soon as you find out that there is a problem with these things. So the next possible reason we see for periodic variation, where periodic variation is a problem in your output saliva. So defective rotational parts or incorrectly coiled slivers, both would lead to a lot of periodic variation. And both these have been discussed at length in earlier lecture. Then again, comber piecing, this will be discussed under comber, but what we need, the remedy would be to adjust the timing of piecing. Then we come to some few more reasons for poor performance of the machine as such, or rather giving us poor material as output. So when I say some other reasons, some of them could be irregular edges of the drafted web. So when the drafted web is coming out of the front roller, the web, the edges might be irregular. And this happens because spread of saliva at feed is excessive. There are damaged roller flutes at some places or the edges, or excessive pressure is applied. Because of all these reasons, one would see irregular edges of the drafted web. So the appropriate action would be to select a saliva guide, which would fix that. Repair the rollers, because if it's damaged, we need to do that. And if it's excessive pressure might be the reason, then reduce the pressure. So some other reasons for poor performance would be saliva breaks in the creel. This would result in partial missing of the web. Also, white trumpet in the previous process would lead to saliva breaks in the creel. Inadequate humidity would also lead to saliva breaks. So check what we should do is check for the damaged card clothing if there is a missing web. And if the trumpet is wide, then we are sure that the compactness of the saliva is inadequate. So we need to use an appropriate trumpet and see that saliva breaks are reduced. Then we may also increase the humidity to increase the cohesion between the fibers, so that they become the saliva are stronger, and as a result, saliva breaks in the creel are reduced. So these are some of the problems that we face on draw frame, and along with the remedies. So with this, we come to the end of the lecture. Thank you.